Dear students, in continuation of tenses, today we will study about present perfect tense. Now see, what is the formula? Subject plus has have plus third form of the verb and object. Now see the formation in affirmative sentence. Has or have are you to be used? Has with he, she, it and singular nouns, and have with I, you, we, they and plural nouns. Now look at the example. He has done his homework. See, according to the formula, subject, he is the subject, then with he we will use has. He has and third form of the verb. Do is the verb and third form of do is done. He has done his homework. Another sentence. I have lost my pen. With I we will use have. And third form of the verb lose is lost. I have lost my pen. Another example. The soldiers have fought bravely. I told you with plural nouns we will use have. And here the soldiers, S means it is a plural noun. So we will use have here. And third form of fight is fought. The soldiers have fought bravely. Another example. The thief, it is a singular noun. The thief has stolen the money. Third form of steal is stolen. And thief is a singular noun. With a singular noun, we will use has. And in negative sentences, we will place not between the verb and the helping verb. Example, he has not done his homework. See, this is the helping verb and the main verb. So in between we will place not. He has not done his homework. They have not won the match. Now in interrogative sentences, has, have, etc. is placed before the subject. Means you will start with has or have and then the subject and then third form of the verb. Look at the example. Has he done his homework? Same formula. With he we will use has, but we will start with has in interrogative sentences. Has or have. Has he done, third form of the verb, his homework? Another example. Have you lost your book? With you will use have. So start with have and third form of the verb. Another example. Has Sita not come to school today? It is a interrogative but negative also. So you will place not in between the subject and the main verb. You will start with has. Has Sita not come to school today? Now we will see where present perfect tense is used. First one, to denote an action that has just been completed. Example, he has just gone out. So the action has been completed just now only. So at that time you will use present perfect tense. Has plus third form of the verb. Gone is the third form of go. Another example. They have reached home safely. With they you will use have. And third form of the verb reach is reached. They have reached home safely. So to denote an action that has been just completed, at that time you will use present perfect tense. Another use, to describe some past events and emphasizing the present importance or effect also. For example, Corona has killed many people. So here you are denoting the present importance also. The students have gone on tour. With plural noun, you will use have and third form of the verb. Another use, to express some past experience whose time is not given. Example, my father has worked with Gandhiji. Means it is in past experience, but the time is not given. I have seen the Taj Mahal in moonlight. So it is in past experience, and the formula same will remain, has have plus third form of the verb. Seen is the third form of see. See, saw, seen. Now I am giving you an exercise based on present perfect tense. You have to solve it.